Hello, in this PixaFlux video tutorial, you will learn how to create the PBR textures for these hexagonal swimming pool tiles. Drag and drop the hexagonal PNG bitmap into the node graph. The tiles for this normal map were modeled in Blender and baked in xNormal. These tiles will be used as a seed for the tile pattern, and we have in this image 4 tiles with small variations to give some more realism to the final pattern. Drag and drop a common tiles node. Set the number of input tiles to 2x2. This tells the common tiles node how the tiles are arranged in the input image. Set the number of output tiles to 4x4. Set the output constraint to distance. The distance constraint allows us to define the distance between the centers of two adjacent tiles in X and Y. The advantage of this distance constraint is that it doesn't change the aspect ratio of the output tiles. Set the output distance to 256 by 256. Since we have 4x4 tiles, this will make the final image size 1024 by 1024. Set the output offset to Y and the offset ratio to 0.5. This will move the second and fourth columns up, allowing us to interlace the hexagons. Set the output scale to a value that just leaves a small gap between the tiles. Now set the output distance in Y. This hexagonal pattern looks good. Now let's create the color texture. Drag and drop a random noise node. We'll use this node to give the tiles a soft sandy texture. Add a 2M node to convert this image to monochromatic. Add a curves node to adjust the saturation of the image. Click to add a new control point. This image will be the mask for the tile colors. Drag and drop a blend node holding down Shift to turn off auto-connect. Connect the curves output as mask. Set the background color to dark blue. Set the foreground color to light blue. Add a resize node and increase the size to make the grains larger. Set the interpolation to linear. Now let's crop the image with the reframe node. We need to resize it to the same size of the input tile's normal image. We can check the size of the input tile's normal image with the info window. 1024 by 887. Resize the texture. Now let's transfer the alpha map from the input tile's normal image to the color texture. Use a split channels node to get access to just the alpha channel. Connect the input tile's normal image. Add a mask channel after the reframe node to add or replace the alpha channel of the color texture. And now connect the color tiles to the common tiles node. We can also use the alpha channel of the input tile's normal image for roughness and metalness. So let's connect it to the second socket in the common tiles node. The common tiles node mixes color images using their alpha channel. Since the outputs of the split channels node are monochromatic, the common tiles node doesn't mix them correctly. We can convert the alpha image to value color mode, because the common tiles node mixes value images by maximum value. Drag a to value node and drop it on top of the connection. Perfect. Now let's set up the model viewport, model and textures. Drag and drop a scene textures node and connect the color tiles to the albedo socket. Open the model viewport. Add a sky image for global illumination. Set the model to box, and set the tile in U and V. Since the common tile's output height is larger than its width, we need to compensate with more tiles in U. Since these tiles are 100% dielectric, let's add a black image as the metalness texture. set the size of this image to 1024 by 1180. This is the size of the common tiles output image. For the roughness, we can use the tiles pattern generated by the alpha channel of the input tiles normal image. Add a curves node and connect the image. Invert the curve to give a low roughness value to the tiles and high roughness to the grout. Now let's do the normal texture. Add a to normal node after the input tiles normal image. Connect it to the common tiles third socket. And connect it to the normal input socket on scene textures. Let's use some purling noise to increase the bumpiness. Set the size to 1024 by 1180 and the frequency to 16 by 16. Add to normal node and set source to height and filter to pre-width 3 by 3. Add a blend normal node to blend the tile's normal image with the purling noise bumpiness. Connect the images. Let's rotate the sky image to see how this bumpiness looks. Too much. Decrease it a bit in the to normal node with the multiply attribute. Lower. Maybe 0.2 is better. Now let's add the grout color and bumpiness. Add a purling noise and set the size to 1024 by 1180. And the frequency to 128 by 128. Set octaves to 4. Add a curves node to make the images brighter. Drag a blend node and connect the grout as background and the color tiles as foreground. Connect the output as the albedo scene texture. Now drag and drop a to normal node and set the source to height. This is the bumpiness of the grout. Add a blend node to mix the grout normal map with the tiles normal map using the alpha channel of the tiles. Excellent. Now let's add some random variations to our tiles to give them more realism. Activate the common tiles node. Set the input symmetry to hexagon. This allows the common tiles node to rotate the tiles randomly in 60 degrees steps. Set the random rotation to 0.1. This means that the maximum random rotation will be 10% of the 60 degrees defined by the hexagon symmetry. Let's try 0.01. Better. Set scale to 0.1. This will scale down each tile by a random value no larger than 10%. Too much. 0.01 is better. Set translation to 0.01. This value translates the tiles in X and Y, a percentage of the distance between the tiles. 0.005 might be better. We can also add variation to the color of the tiles with the hue, saturation, and value attributes. Set hue to 0.1. Set it to 0.025. Set saturation to 0.02. Set value to 0.01. Excellent. Let's check all our PBR textures. Albedo, metalness, roughness, and normal. And this is how you can use the Common Tiles node to generate tiles, and PixaFlux to create and compose PBR textures. Thank you for watching this PixaFlux video tutorial. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, or follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+.